So now we are very close to the final solution. We already got the data that is required to be preserved, but still there is some unnecessary information, which is product ID, which we don't need. And also data has to be sorted in the ascending order by date and descending order by revenue. And then we have to get the final output as date comma, revenue comma, product name after sorting the data. So now to sort the data, again, we can use the API called sort by key, and sort by key requires appropriate key on which data needs to be sorted. And here the requirement is we need to sort on composite key, which is order date as well as order revenue, daily revenue per product. And on order date, we have to sort in ascending order, and with revenue, we have to sort in descending order. Okay, so how we can do that? First, we have to discard order ID. Okay, so the output for this after joining is like this. We got order product ID, not order ID, comma, order date. I can actually copy this thing and then product name. Okay, this is how the data is represented after joining. After sorting, how the data has to be? It has to be like this. The final outcome before getting to desired output has to be order date ascending and daily revenue per product descending. Okay, and then value has to be even if you have only product name, it is good enough, but as part of this sorting process, we will negate this daily revenue product ID so that data is sorted in descending order. That's why I am going to capture all the three fields, date, revenue, as well as name, as one tuple. Okay, so in this, we'll get order date. When we save, we don't want to save the negative values of revenue. So here we need to get daily revenue per product. Okay, and then I want to get the product name. This is the final output which I want to get. Okay, so again, to achieve this, after sorting the first we need to sort the data, and also we might have to apply the map function on it, and I will do it both in one shot. Okay, so let's write the logic. So let me create val daily revenue per product sorted equal to daily revenue per product join dot map, and I don't need this. Instead, I want this, but the key has to be order date in ascending order date and negation of daily revenue so that data is sorted in descending order. Okay, so here I am saying it as rec, and the outcome has to be we have to capture everything, order date, daily revenue per product, as well as product name. Okay, so here the key has to be rec dot underscore 2, which gives us this one, and then rec dot underscore 2 dot underscore 1 again gives the tuple, which is this one. And to get the order date, I just have to say underscore 1, and then I can use negation to sort the data in descending order because order item subtotal is of type float, which is of type numeric, and reg dot underscore 2 dot underscore 1 dot underscore 2 will give this one, and I have negated this. Okay, now I want to capture the values as is so that we don't get negation as part of the revenue. So I'm copy pasting these things, and in this case the value tuple will have three elements. One is date, second one is revenue, third one is product name. And to extract product name, it has to be reg dot underscore 2 will give this one, reg dot underscore 2 dot underscore 2 will give this one. So I just have to say reg dot underscore 2 dot underscore 2. Okay, and then once you do the transformation, this does not sort the data. We are just applying the transformation to come up with the key and the value. And to sort, you just say sort by key. Okay, and now you can run this. Paste and hit enter. So something is missing here. Okay, the brackets are not used properly. There has to be one more set of bracket, because the entire output is a key value pair. For sort by key also, we need to pass paired RDD. So in map, I haven't created a paired RDD earlier. Now by putting the entire logic in circular brackets, it has become the paired RDD. Still some things are missing. Let me fix it. I know what is the issue. It is issue with the sublime text. I have to add one more circular bracket at the end. Okay, you can validate. If you see, if you keenly observe, if you are using sublime text, you will see underscore under this circular bracket and matching circular bracket. So this is matched with this one. And then the second one from the right is matched with second one from the left. And this one is matched with this one. And this one is matched with this one. Having matching circular brackets is very, very important. Now it will work. And you can preview the data by using dot takeoff 10 dot for each println. Let me preview more records here. Make sure that data is sorted as expected. Earlier when we preview the data is random. After 2013 November 19th, we got 2014 April 1st. Whereas here, data is sorted by date. You can see all 27s are together, all 26s are together, all 28s are together. Okay, and then you got the data in descending order under each date. For example, if you take 25th, you can see that data within 2013 July 25th, the data is sorted in descending order by revenue. The first one which has generated highest amount of revenue is Field and Stream Sportsman 16 Gunfire Safe. The second one is Nike Men's Free Running Shoe, and it has generated $5,099.49 in revenue. This is how you can get the information. And now is this output matching our requirement? No. Still we have the key. I don't want this. And we have the value, and the value is also tuple. I don't want tuple as value. Instead, I need a string. So I need to apply further transformation. Before applying further transformation, let me copy this code, which is used for the preview purpose, onto this one. Now let us work on getting the data in desired format as well. Okay, So taking this daily revenue per product sorted, val daily revenue per product is my final variable name. Taking sorted, I can use the map function, and I can discard this key completely. I just generated this key to sort the data. After that, we can just discard. So I can say rec implies, to get this tuple, I can just say rec.underscore2. But still, data is a tuple. You will have the circle brackets, and even though comma you will see in between, still that is not the format we want. We want a plain string with delimiter of our choice. In this case, it's comma. So on a tuple, there is a function called mkstring. It's not only on tuple, on any collection as well as tuple. If you want to iterate through all the elements and apply a delimiter on all the elements and convert into a single string with a delimiter, then we can use this mkstring or makestring function. Makestring function is the function which can be applied on any collection to convert into a string. So n number of records in a collection will be converted to one string with the delimiter which we pass here. So comma is the delimiter which I want to use. Now, I can say dot take of 10 dot for each println. So there is some typo on this. Let me see what is the error. Okay, rec dot underscore two dot make string is not a member of string float string. Okay, so in that case, what I have to do is if all the, I think for make string all the elements needs to be string. If this doesn't work, there is an alternative. What I can do, I can read each of the elements like rec dot underscore two dot underscore one, and then give the delimiter and concatenate with the next element, which is rec dot underscore two dot underscore two plus delimiter plus rec dot underscore two dot underscore three. Underscore two will give this one. Underscore one will give this, underscore two will give this, underscore three will give this after rec dot underscore two. Now let us run this. Now it worked, and let us preview the data. If all the elements are of type string, then you can use the make string function without any issues. Now you got the data the way we want. We got the date first, we got the revenue for the topmost product by revenue generated by the topmost product for a given day, and the product name, and we got the information the way we want. So this is how you can sort the data. And also, after sorting, typically we use map to transform the data the way we want. So in this case, we have used means to come to the final output, we have used se.txt file to read the text data, se.parallelize to convert collection to RDD. We have used filter for completed and closed orders. We have used map to convert into key value pairs for each and every data set so that we can perform join by using join API. We have used reduce by key to aggregate. And finally, we also use sort by key to sort the data, and we have used map wherever we need a record in an RDD has to be transformed to a different format we have used map quite extensively. So this is how you can take a problem statement, come up with the design, and start writing the code. And finally, we have to save this into a file, and it is very straightforward. I'm passing daily revenue, saving it in Avro format for now, because I haven't covered the file formats extensively. But to save as text file, it's very straightforward. We can just take this daily revenue per product and then say save as text file, and we just have to give the path. In this case, the path is user dgadraju, which is my account name, and then daily revenue text underscore scala. And let's copy paste this one also. Once it is done, there are multiple ways to preview the data. One way is to just use sc.txt file, because it's text data. So we can now actually read sc.txt file and give this path. Okay, so it will read the data from the file again, and you can actually preview the data by saying take of 10 for each println, just to make sure that data is copied properly and we are able to read it. And also make sure that there are no exceptions after running this save as text file, and then paste it. And you can see the data. Okay, we got the data the way we want. Also, you can actually run Hadoop fs-ls on the same path. Let me copy paste that path. To see that files are generated. And also you can say Hadoop fs minus cat or tail to actually preview the data. With cat you can use patterns. Like this. But cat will print everything, and it may take a bit of time. See here, it took some time, but it facilitates us to look at the entire data. Data is sorted in ascending order by date, and then in descending order by revenue. And also we got date, revenue, and product name. Okay, if you want to use tail just to preview few records, you can do that with the fully qualified name of your file, which is part -00000 or 01. There are two files. One is with 5 zeros and the one is with 4 zeros and 1. You can tail into both the files. Okay, so this is how you can preview the data. Once the data is saved into HDFS, you have to make sure that this validation is done. You have to make sure that file is saved in the file format as per the certification requirement. And also, if it is text file format, the delimiter is correct. If it has to be compressed, you have to compress. And I have already explained how to compress earlier. And finally, if you look at the problem statement, we also have to copy data from HDFS to local file system into this directory. For that, there is a command called Hadoop fs-get. Let me copy this. I'm trying to get the entire directory, and the location is home/dgadraju daily revenue scala. Paste and hit enter. Now you should go to daily revenue scala directory, and you should validate that the files are copied. So here there is one caveat. Let's say I want to copy the directory, not the files. in this case, what happened? Whatever files that are there in this directory are copied to this directory. But if I want to copy the directory itself, not just the files. So let me remove these files. Okay. So here what we have to do, we have to say Hadoop fs hyphen get daily revenue scalar, just put slash and then give dot. Then what will happen? The directory will be copied to this location. Okay. Or to be safer side, you can also say daily revenue txt scalar. If it fails because this directory is not there, then probably let me do this. So I am removing daily revenue scalar. So let's say the requirement is to copy this Hadoop fs hyphen get daily revenue text scalar as a directory into this daily revenue scalar. So if I just say this again, what will happen? It will actually copy files from this location to the directory which will be created here, and it will copy files to this location. If I want to get directory itself, you can actually say like this, revenue text scalar, and hit enter. It says no such file or directory because this directory is not there in the path. So what you have to do ideally, you have to say mkdir, copy this path. And paste it and then run it. Then you will get daily revenue text scalar to be copied to daily revenue scalar that we can validate by saying cd daily revenue scalar, daily revenue text scalar, and ls-ltr. You can see the files here. Okay, so these are the things which you need to keep in mind to copy the data to the local file system. And let me copy and add it to this file to close it out. And I'm deleting this. Okay, and also we can actually put backward slash in Linux to line break a long command. Okay, so this is one command which will copy the files. And before this, I also want to do mkdir. I also want to run mkdir command to create this directory. Okay, so this is how you can copy data from HDFS into the local file system into the desired directory. That being said, we are done with the solution for the problem statement. It's a very simple problem statement. It says get the daily revenue per product ID in ascending order by date and descending order by get the daily revenue per product in ascending order by date and descending order by revenue. And the final output has to be the date, the revenue, and the product name. And it has to be saved into the HDFS as well as local file system. And we have written approximately 60 to 70 lines of code to achieve that. I think not even 60 to 70. If you actually break down the transformations which we have used, probably it is 30 lines of code. And with 30 lines of code, we are able to accomplish this. So this is how you need to come up with the solution. And when it comes to certification, the questions will be much, much easier. All the questions together also will not be as complicated as this problem statement. Most of the times, they give a data set and they will ask you to filter. They give the data set, and they might ask you to sort. They give the data set and they might ask you to save it into a file system. After doing a simple transformation in the desired format, probably compressed and something like that. So that is how the questions will be. So don't worry that you have to write this much of code within 20 minutes for one question, because there will be 8 to 12 questions and you have to complete within 2 hours. If they give one question like this, it will take almost 1 hour for expert to write this code. I don't think they will go to this level at the time of certification. Most likely they will give you much, much simpler tasks. But once you understand the flow, it will be easier for you to combine the APIs to get the desired outcome as per the problem statement. So make sure you practice well, not only with this. You can be creative by yourself and come up with your own problem statements and practice as much as you can. That being said, now we will wrap up the core transformations and actions under transform stage and store module, and we will move on to the other stuff. Thank you.